A Course in Miracles. Text. Chapter 25. The Justice of God. Section 7. The Special Function. The grace of God rests gently on forgiving eyes, and everything they look on speaks of Him to the beholder. He can see no evil, nothing in the world to fear, and no one who is different from Himself. And as He loves them, so He looks upon Himself with love and gentleness. He would no more condemn Himself for His mistakes than damn another. He is not an arbiter of vengeance, nor a punisher of sin. The kindness of His sight rests on Himself, with all the tenderness it offers others. For He would only heal and only bless. And being in accord with what God wills, He has the power to heal and bless all those He looks on, with the grace of God upon His sight. Eyes become used to darkness, and the light of brilliant day seems painful to the eyes, grown long accustomed to the dim effects perceived at twilight. And they turn away from sunlight and the clarity it brings to what they look upon. Dimness seems better, easier to see, and better recognized. Somehow the vague and more obscure seems easier to look upon, less painful to the eyes than what is wholly clear and unambiguous. Yet this is not what eyes are for, and who can say that he prefers the darkness and maintain he wants to see? The wish to see calls down the grace of God upon your eyes and brings the gift of light that makes sight possible. Would you behold your brother? God is glad to have you look on him. He does not will your Savior be unrecognized by you, nor does he will that he remain without the function that he gave to him. Let him no more be lonely, for the lonely ones are those who see no function in the world for them to fill, no place where they are needed, and no aim which only they can perfectly fulfill. Such is the Holy Spirit's kind perception of specialness, His use of what you made to heal instead of harm. To each He gives a special function in salvation He alone can fill, apart for only Him. Nor is the plan complete until He finds His special function and fulfills the part assigned to Him to make Himself complete within a world wherein completion rules. Here, where the laws of God do not prevail in perfect form, can He yet do one perfect thing and make one perfect choice? And by this act of special faithfulness to one perceived as other than Himself, He learns the gift was given to Himself, and so they must be one. Forgiveness is the only function meaningful in time. It is the means the Holy Spirit uses to translate specialness from sin into salvation. Forgiveness is for all. But when it rests on all, it is complete, and every function of this world completed with it. Then is time no more. Yet while in time, there is still much to do. And each must do what is allotted him, for on his part does all the plan depend. He has a special part in time, for so he chose, and choosing it, he made it for himself. His wish was not denied but changed in form, to let it serve his brother and himself, and thus become a means to save, instead of lose. Salvation is no more than a reminder, this world is not your home. Its laws are not imposed on you, its values are not yours. And nothing that you think you see in it is really there at all. This is seen and understood as each one takes his part in its undoing, as he did in making it. He has the means for either as he always did. The specialness he chose to hurt himself did God appoint to be the means for his salvation, from the very instant that the choice was made. His special sin was made his special grace. His special hate became his special love. The Holy Spirit needs your special function, that his may be fulfilled. Think not ye lack a special value here. You wanted it, and it is given you. All that you made can serve salvation easily and well. The Son of God can make no choice the Holy Spirit cannot employ on his behalf, and not against himself. Only in darkness does your specialness appear to be attack. In light, you see it as your special function in the plan to save the Son of God from all attack, and let him understand that he is safe, as he has always been, and will remain in time and in eternity alike. This is the function given you for your brother. Take it gently, then, from your brother's hand, and let salvation be perfectly fulfilled in you. Do this one thing, that everything be given you.